Hello my dear students, today we'll start from the remaining portion of the differences between the solid, liquid and gas, that is for class 9. So already we have discussed that solid, liquid, gas, we are comparing the three states of matter. So as I have told that solid, if we represent that particles in a solid are very closely packed, tightly packed with each other, very little space is or almost nil space is present between them, they are strongly, there is strong attraction between the particles or atoms, whereas in case of a liquid, the particles have little space, moderate space between them. They can move from each other. They can move. Whereas in case of gas, much more space is present and they can move randomly from one place to another. There is little attraction is there. And from this diagram you can compare one characteristic, we'll compare, that is the number fourth one, compressibility. Compressibility means ability to compress. So what is the meaning of compressibility? That is ability to compress. So the solid, as the atoms or the particles are tightly packed, they cannot be compressed. So I can write here the compressibility nature of solid is least or nil compressible. They cannot be compressed. And whereas in case of liquid, it is little compressible. As the little space is there between them. And gas is highly compressible. Why? Because they have much more space between them. So they can be compressed. I can show you. You can take a syringe here, you can see. So if you pull the piston here, so now the air is present inside the syringe or piston. So keep the thumb here, you can see. And when I will press it, you can see that air can be pressed up to this. Then if you leave it, again it will come to the original position. What does it mean? That air can be compressed easily. How? Because they have much more space between them, and that is why we can make it compressed to a very little extent. Okay, so then we'll go to the next, is rigidity. Rigidity means, you can say, the hardness. Hardness, as you see in the diagram, when the particles are very close to each other, they are tightly packed, so they are tight or they have very much rigidity. So solids have rigidity. Or they are rigid in nature, whereas less rigidity and rigidity is nil, because they are moving from each other. So I can write here no rigidity in case of gas. Then we'll discuss the last one is called diffusion. What is the meaning of it? The diffusion means intermixing of two or more matters. When two or more matters intermix with each other, the process is called diffusion. So as you know that when you take a agarbatti and light it, you see that the smoke coming from the agarbatti, it easily mix with the air. So the smoke of from the agarbatti mixes with the air, so that is also a process of diffusion. So diffusion takes place in case of gas very fastly. So if you compare the difference, so I can say the solids, no diffusion takes place between the solids. No diffusion between solids. Two solids cannot be diffused. If we keep these two pair, the particles of these two pair will not mix with each other. So no diffusion takes place in case of solids. Whereas in case of liquid, diffusion takes place. You know that if you will take one drop of Dettol in a mug of water, you will see that the Dettol drop, that is a liquid, it can easily mix with the water. Similarly, if you will put water in milk, water and milk, they can easily mix with each other. So the diffusion takes place between the liquids and gases. The diffusion also takes place. Diffusion takes place very fastly because you know that gases particles have much more movement. They can easily move from each other because of less attraction. That is why two gases, if you keep, they can easily mix with each other. So diffusion rate is highest in case of gases. Liquid can diffuse into each other, not all the liquid, some liquid, but between two solids no diffusion takes place. So this is the differences between the characteristic of solid state, liquid state and gaseous state. Then we'll move to the next session of this chapter, that is interconversion of states of matter. Means you know that different states can be interconverted, they can be changed into one another. So think that this is solid, this is liquid, and this is gas.